In today's tutorial, we're going to talk about how to make an assembly. You can see I have three files open. They're little Lego block parts that I modeled. They aren't at all exact, but they're approximately what a little Lego pieces look like. And to start with, I'm going to make a new part file. So I'll click on New, and I'll choose to open an assembly instead of a part. So it's the little part icon, but then with a little block filling in the corner. When I open an assembly, I'm taken to a page that looks like this. And you'll notice since I have three files open, they appear in the left-hand side. And how an assembly works is in an assembly file, we can take different parts in SolidWorks and mate them together. And what that means is we put geometric constraints on them, similar to relations, that constrain the parts to be in a particular orientation. The first part we select, if we click on it and drag it over, is going to be fixed in space. And so this is now the part off of which all other parts are going to be mated. I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. And I want to insert some more parts. And so I can go to the Assembly tab and say Insert Components. And all of my open files appear here. So I could do another 1x4. And maybe I'll insert a 1x2. And then lastly, I'm going to insert a file that I don't have open here. So I can click on Browse. And this brings up all my different part files. And I'm going to insert a 2x4 part. Okay, so these are my basic building blocks for the assembly that I'm going to make. How we mate parts together is similar to how we did with relations, except now we're using surfaces typically. So in this case, maybe I would like to put the blue block on top of the red block. And so what I can do is I can select the top surface of the red block, roll around so I can see the bottom surface of the blue block, hold Control, and click on that bottom surface, okay? And then I want to go up to the toolbar and click on Mate, which is a little paper clip. And what SolidWorks is going to do is it's going to slide that blue block up and put a coincident mate on it. This is what it thinks. It has a smart mate functionality, and so it automatically guesses what you think you want. And I'll say, I do want that. And you can align or anti-align. That button's down here below all of the features in the property manager. If you pick anti-align, it flips the part over, but I liked how it was before, so I'm going to click OK. All right. Now if I click on the blue block, I can still move it around in my part file, but what I can't do is if I look at the side, I can't move it up and down. When I do that, it looks like I'm moving it up and down, but I'm actually moving it front to back. So what's happening here is that the part is constrained so that the bottom surface of the blue block will always be in contact with this top surface of the red block. So I can keep going. Maybe I want the blocks to be flush with each other, so I can add another mate by selecting those two surfaces. If I like it, I can just right-click as a little shortcut. Next, I select the two side surfaces, right-click, and now it's fully constrained. It's tied to that first part, and remember, my first part is fixed, and so I can't move it, and it's not going to move around. Let's go ahead and move the yellow block into position. I want to show you another type of mate. You can also, if you have two cylindrical surfaces, let me get out of the mate command here. I'm going to put my yellow block on going sideways here. And if you have two cylindrical surfaces, you can select both their faces and then click on the paperclip in the flyout tree. That will give you the mate. And that applies what's called a concentric mate. And this makes it, if you have two cylindrical surfaces, it makes it so that their center axis is aligned and coincident. And so this is what I want, so I'll go ahead and click check. And now I'm going to grab that yellow part, and you can see I can move it around, I can rotate it, but that corner cylinder is always going to be right in line, like I would expect there. And maybe the next thing I want to do is I want to constrain it from moving up and down, so I can select the top surface of the block, then roll around and get the bottom surface of the blue block, okay? And it automatically moves into the position I want. And then lastly, I'll select these two surfaces, and it will go ahead and constrain it. So now it's fully constrained. Okay, so we're just building a little Lego model here. Maybe this last guy, I can move him around. If I want to rotate a part to get it closer to in position, I can click on Move Component, or if I click down, I can click on Rotate Component. And then if I grab the part, I can spin it around in space to get it closer to how I want it to be. Okay, so now I'll escape out of that command, select this surface and select the yellow surface of the 1x4 block. I'll mate those together and then mate. Let me get out of this guy, sorry. I forgot to select accept, so it didn't apply that mate. I'll click on mate, right click to accept it, and now I can apply another mate between these. Okay, and then the last one, I need to zoom in here, select the bottom surface and the top surface, and it moves into position and we're good. Okay, so that's a really simple little assembly. There's lots more advanced mates you can do. If you want to put in another block, this is a neat little shortcut. If I want another blue block, I can hold control, click on the block, and then drag it away while still holding control. Oops, I have to be out of my mate command. So I click on this guy. If I hold control and click on him, I can drag another instance. And you'll see over in my feature tree, now I have two 2x4 blocks, okay? Maybe I want to mate this guy to be some particular distance. First, I'll put mate these two ends to be coincident. And I'll say that's good. And I want them to be at the same level, so I'll select the top surface of this one and the top surface of the other one, make them at the same level. And then I can put a mate between these two to put them side by side. But maybe I actually want to have them be some distance apart. And so I can choose that here, and I'm going to say I want them to be 0.6 inches apart. Okay. And then now this blue block, the second blue block, is constrained to be at that distance. All right. I'm going to connect those by grabbing another yellow block. So I hold control and drag. I could also do this by going to insert components and insert another component. And now I'm going to connect these guys by making the two cylinders concentric here. So I'll add a mate to make those concentric. I'll accept that to be okay. And then I'm going to put another mate on here. And look, this has over-constrained my problem. So what's happened is that I've put one too many mates on this, and so it won't allow it. I could either remove the distance relationship between the two blue blocks, or I could not put this mate on. And in this case, I'm going to choose to not put this mate on. I instead will mate this side to this side and let them be coincident. And then I will mate the bottom of that block to the top of this block. Okay, and that flies into position. All right, so similar to making sure a sketch is fully defined, you want to make sure that your assemblies only allow motion where you want them to allow motion. So in this case, I don't want any of these parts to be able to rotate. And so that has happened correctly for me. We'll talk more about how to use the motion manager and create animations. But for now, enjoy making your assemblies.